We're talking about the terror attack that killed four Americans in Libya. But for the victims of that attack, did that interview really offer the real answers for them, or was it politics? The Senate Minority Whip, John Cornyn of Texas, joins us now live on the Curvy Couch. Good to see you.
Good morning.
Morning.
So I'm sure you saw the interview. The first half talked just about their friendship, and I was like, oh, I hope they ask questions about Libya. After the commercial break, they did, in fact, talk about Benghazi. But were the answers sufficient for you?
You know, it seems like this is more of a PR initiative than it is an effort to get to the bottom of things. And I know I watched the hearings some months after the incident, and Secretary Clinton said, you know, what's the big deal here, or words to that effect. Well, the big deal is four Americans lost their lives, and we ought to be about trying to figure out how do we prevent that from ever happening again, and how do we hold the people who were responsible accountable.
Sure. Do you think we're ever going to get to the bottom of this?
Well, I hope our friends in the House of Representatives will not let this go, and we'll get to the bottom of it. It's important to our national security. It's important to protect our diplomats and those abroad who are representing the United States. This is not about politics. This is not about personalities. This is really about keeping our commitments to those people who represent the United States abroad in dangerous places and making sure they're protected.
Sure.
One of the other controversial things that's going to be happening on the Hill now is the confirmation, or maybe not, of Chuck Hagel. How do you feel about the former senator becoming the basically in charge of the world affairs in defense?
Well, I like Chuck Hagel. I served with Chuck Hagel in the United States Senate, but he's the wrong man for this job.
Why?
Well, his positions on everything from a nuclear Iran to direct negotiations with State Department designated terrorist organizations like Hamas, his embrace of these naive ideas like a nuclear free world, which, you know, is fine to say, you know, I hope and I wish and I pray that it would be that way, but it's not realistic and it's naive, particularly among the person who's supposed to represent American national security and keep the peace. And I worry that President Obama has picked Senator Hagel because really the Defense Department is the only part of the government that he seems to be willing to cut. He's not really interested in reining and spending in almost any other area except national security. He said the sequester, which of course are the $1.2 trillion in cuts that are scheduled to go in effect, which disproportionately affect defense spending, the president said during the campaign, ain't going to happen.
Right.
Well, it's going to happen, and it's going to happen here in just about 6 weeks.
Before you go, something that looks like it's going to happen in your chamber, the Senate, is it looks like there's a bipartisan plan to reform immigration. What do you think?
Well, I hope so, and we'll hear from the president this week, but it really requires presidential leadership, like so many of these issues, because it's easy for people to sort of get off in their corner and argue their particular agenda, but it's hard to come together on big, complex.
So it's up to the president?
Well, it's up to all of us, but the president's got to play his role as commander-in-chief and leader.
And we should mention that eight Republicans have come together to talk about immigration reform as well, and they are going to come up with their own plan. Some people are saying this will be amazing if this actually happens, but we'll have to wait and see.
Got to pass both houses of Congress, and we got a lot of work to do.
That's right. All right. Senator Cornyn, real pleasure. Thanks for joining us live here in New York.
Good to see both of you. Thank you.
Good to see you. Senator.